Just a quick overview of the SmartWeight Pro balancer. The first thing when you walk up on the machine is you'll likely notice these two knobs. There's one below and one above the weight tray. The one below the weight tray we're going to use to enter dimensions of the wheel, and it moves a laser dot, and we'll talk about that a little bit later. But basically, it's going to replace the data set arms. If you remember, on most traditional balancers, we have arms. Those are replaced with this. You'll also notice that there's a metal housing on the outside here that's going to replace the outer data set. Above the weight tray, you'll see this knob here, and this knob is going to be used to change dimensions and change modes on the screen. On the weight tray, you'll see there are little spaces here where we can store our economy collets, and also there are pegs underneath the machine where we can store additional cups and things like that. Optionally, there can also be a storage carrier that's added here where you can place the 10 bullseye collet kit. So that's just a quick overview of the machine. All right, now let's talk a little bit about controlling the interface. That's done from this knob here. And what we do is, basically, as I turn the knob, you'll see the selector moving up and down on the right side of the screen. And when I highlight a button here, I just press the actual button itself, and it takes me into that selection. If I hit the back button here next to the knob, it's going to jump back out. So if I'm in any sort of function where I don't want to be, I can always hit the back button and get out. In this case, I could always hit cancel as well, okay? So this is a centering check feature. This is very important on the balancer. If we see the wheel, we suspect that the wheel is not centering properly, or the adapters may not be correct, we can launch a centering check, and it's going to walk us through how to perform a centering check. Basically, it'll do two different balances and have you jumble things up between those two balances and make sure that everything is in fact centered correctly. So that's a key piece on this machine. If we go to the tools menu, press the button, you'll see I have a number of other different options here. Quick calibration check that we can do with the cal tool, the calibration weight, I should say, from the back to make sure that the balancer is in calibration. We can clean the threads of the spindle. We can do a balance optimization where we'll turn the tire on the rim to get the most efficient balance, use the least amount of weight. Or I can reset the dimensions. Any of those can be selected by pressing the knob, and then I say okay. Now if we roll down to the video player, we can watch a video about what we're doing here, how to use the machine, how to enter dimensions, how to balance a wheel, things like that. So that's going to be something that's very important to use. Now this last selection, I can change the weight mode if I want to switch between clip-clip, tape-tape, wheels, whatever the case may be, I can do that here. So that's a little general overview about how we use the knob. All right, now let's go ahead and balance a wheel. The first thing we need to do is tell it how we want to balance this wheel. So I'm going to select my weight mode, and I'm going to start with a clip-clip balance. And what you'll see is as soon as I touch this lower knob here, it starts an animation on the screen. And the animation shows me exactly where it wants me to put the laser to get a good clip measurement. So it's showing the laser right in the center of that flange. See where that dot's hitting? So that's where I want to make sure my laser is hitting that spot. Once I find that spot, I enter the dimension. And then all I have to do is pull the hood down. It says lower the hood. And the outer dimension was entered automatically by the laser on the outside. So it was just that easy. That's all I had to do. Once it spins it up, it's going to tell me how much weight I need to put on. In this case, it's a 1/2 ounce. It's going to servo to the top where it's easiest to put on my clip weight. I'd bang the clip weight on. In this case, I have the hammerhead laser, so it's shining a laser to show me exactly where to put that clip weight. Okay? So it's just that easy. Now let's go ahead and switch to clip tape mode. So I'm going to select weight mode and say clip tape. So it works almost the same. Grab my inner laser, starts my animation again. Animation says shoot that laser right into the center of the flange. So I put it at the center of the flange, got it right there. Enter that dimension. Now it's going to show me where to put the tape weight. So it says put the laser right in the center where you want the tape weight to go. So I'll do that over here. Tap the foot pedal. Enters that dimension, you heard the beep, and now we spin it up again. Now, it didn't even need to use the outer laser at this point. So if we had a machine that didn't have the outer laser, that's actually an option, then we'd be okay. If we did have a machine that was missing the outer laser, we would have to enter the width manually. Okay, now in this case, it's the exact same solution. I would put my 1/2 ounce clip weight, bang it on right there, and away we go. Okay, so now what if we want to do a tape-tape? dimension, entry. I'm going to go tape. I select that, turn the animation, or turn the knob. Animation starts on the screen and it says, okay, put the first laser spot right in the center where you want to put the inner tape weight. Tap the foot pedal, it beeps, and now it switches and says, okay, show me where the second tape weight goes. Again, laser spot goes right in the center. Okay. Tap the foot pedal. Pull the hood down to do our spin. It's going to spin it up. Now this time I'll actually put the weight on and balance it. See what it calls for here. It says it wants a half an ounce. Notice its servo's into position. Now if I turn the laser back to where that initial weight was, you'll notice the laser flashes, basically says put the weight right here. So I'm going to take my weight tape off here. Put the weight on just like it shows on the screen, so I've got it in the same orientation as it is there on the screen. Pull the hood down to do a check spin. If I've done everything right, I'll get okay. There it is. We're all finished. All right, so what if we have a fancy wheel and we want to put the weights, the correction weights, behind the spokes? That's easy to do. Let's show you how that's done. So I'll select the weight mode. In this case, we're going to go tape again. So I turn my knob until it's on the inner weight plane, enter that dimension, and go to the outer weight up against the spokes there, and enter that dimension. Now what we do before is we just pull the hood down and balance, but this time I want to say okay, and I'm going to say enter spokes. So what it's showing me on the screen is take the laser, turn the wheel such that the laser is behind that spoke, enter that spoke location, and do that for one more spoke. That's all I have to do. And it's going to paint those spokes all the way around the wheel. So now you'll see on the screen the spokes have been entered. So now when I pull the hood down, it's going to balance the wheel as it did before, but any weights called for on the spoke side are going to be placed in one of those locations. You may see that it needs two, it may need one. In this case, it solved it with one weight. So it's calling for one weight on the inside. If I servo to the outer weight, you notice there's calling for a single weight, but it's right behind the spoke, and I see the laser dot flashing right there. So that's pretty simple to do. Well, what do we do with the next wheel? Well, when I take this wheel off and put the new wheel on, I don't have to re-enter all the dimensions. All I have to do is set a new spoke location, because the wheel's going to look the same if it's from the same set of wheels, right? So I say set new spoke location, spin the wheel until the laser's behind that spoke, and I just re-enter that. Now what it's done is it just re-clocked the wheel on the balancer. So it came up with a new solution. I could do that again for the next wheel. Now I'm onto my third wheel, right? So I balance this one, let's say, bring the new one on, enter the new dimension, and it resets, okay? All right, now what if we want to split the weights? Let's say I don't have the proper weights, or I've got something in an obstruction that I want to move the weights around. So all I do is say, press the split the weight button here. And in this case, I want to split the inner weight. And you'll notice what it does on the screen is it replaced the single weight with two. And if I keep splitting the weights, you'll notice they get larger and they spread out further. Now it's an ounce and a quarter. And then it returns back to a single weight solution. Okay, so I could do the same for the outer weights if I have two. I split them, I can split them again, they get larger. And then eventually larger one more time, and then it's going to go back to a single weight solution. So it's that easy to work around if we have some problem, we don't have the right weight, or whatever the case may be. It's just that easy to split weights. So now let's say we have a problem. Maybe the wheel is really, really shiny, or there's something's obstructing, I can't get good dimensions. Then I'm going to want to enter those dimensions manually. If I had an extremely large wheel, extremely small wheel, some crazy setup, I can do that. And basically, what I have to do is I just say set weight mode, and I'm going to say manual entry, okay? And when I do that, what it's basically asking me to do is select the weight mode, in this case tape, and to do this I have to give it a few dimensions here. The first I have to give it is the dimension from the tub to the first weight plane, and that's what it's asking for right here, so that inner weight. So if I select that, I can change that. So let's say it's at 4.7, I'm going to make it 5.6 inches, I would actually use a tape measure to measure that dimension. When I enter it, then I can change to the next selection. Now it wants to know, in this case, what is the dimension from the tub to the outer weight plane. Okay, 11.3 is fine. If I want to change that, I can. Then I go to the next dimension, right? It needs to know the diameter now. Now it wants me to measure with the tape measure. What's the diameter there? And then what's the diameter at the second location, okay? So I can change any of these. When I'm finished, I roll over to okay, and we're finished. So we've entered dimensions manually. So that's a basic overview of how we balance wheels with the SmartWeight Pro.